Welcome back to RG Geek. I'm continuing my coverage of the Game & Watch Super Mario Bros. Color Edition, which just came out. And if you want to see the unboxing video, or you want to see the language error, I have separate videos for that. Go check them out on my channel. Alright, so let's get into the review. Imagine you're first interested mostly in the games, so let's go to the games. So you'll notice already here, you have 2020, that means they've modified the software a bit. I haven't found anything that's changed in the actual gameplay, but that's interesting to note that it is a different version, so there might be Easter eggs in here that I haven't found yet. You see it plays great. I find it a bit rough with these small controls, because this game was meant to be played with a bigger D-pad and bigger buttons. But I love that it stays true to its original form. So, and right, I can show you the pause screen. You can adjust the volume right here, and you can adjust the brightness, and reset the game. Now I think it's, and there's the time and the battery life as well. I think it's kind of sad there's no headphone jack. So if you want to play it, say in public or without annoying people around you, you have to play it without sound, basically, but that's still pretty cool. So I want to show you another feature. If you go into Mario 2, or as it's known in the West as Lost Levels, you'll see I already was in the middle of a game. It auto-saves, so whenever you quit, you'll come straight back into the game where you left off, and you can just keep playing. And I'm playing as Luigi here, so in Luigi in this version jumps higher, but also stops more difficultly. And I can get a poisonous mushroom over here and die. Very cool. Alright, now let's look at the last game. So they have two games, just like in the tradition when they released this in 1980. Game A and Game B. Game A is basically the easy version, which is really not interesting to most gamers, I would believe. But of course, it needs to be there for historical reasons. And Game B is the more interesting game, where you're juggling three balls, but it's still pretty easy. I like it keeps the high score for you, even when you turn off the machine and everything like that. I find it a bit disappointing that they didn't include more games on here. Like, it would have been really neat to have, say, Super Mario Land or Super Mario Land 2. Because Super Mario Land itself is only 37 kilobytes, which is, like, tiny to put on a device like this. Maybe they had some issues with making it pixel perfect in those situations. So I can understand that, but it would still be nice to have. You could also put in some other Nintendo games. I mean, they range from 25 kilobytes up to half a megabyte, so it's really not much space at all. If I actually wanted to play Super Mario Brothers, I would probably pick up my RG350M. And for those of you who are hardcore handheld people out there, probably already even have this. So, but you have to remember this is about twice the price of this, and the grip is an extra 10 bucks. So, as you can see, the screen size is just so much nicer to play. And it just feels more comfortable too. So, you can see here the difference in the screen size between the RG350M and the Game & Watch. And obviously there's more save states, manual save states, and you have extra settings you can go into as well. So if I just want to play Mario, I'll probably pick this up actually. But I know you're not getting the Game & Watch just to play Mario. You're getting it because it's a feeling of nostalgia from the old days. That's totally cool. And I'm super happy I got it. It looks amazing. I probably won't play it that often, but it's really cool to have and to show it to people who come over. They play it for a few minutes and it's just a fun experience. So, let's get into the watch version, the watch part of this, which is part of the title, Game & Watch. So one thing I find annoying is that there is no kickstand, which I'm hearing a lot of people complaining about. And so you see how it looks on the original Super Mario Brothers from 1988. You just can put that in, stays flat, or you pull it out. And I don't know why they didn't include that this time, because it would have been really nice to have, especially if you want to use it as a clock. Since you need something like this, a stand. I've also heard that if you look up plate holder, then those are also really nice for holding handhelds. So that would be my recommendation. This is an old iPad holder here, so using it for the video to keep it still. I'm also disappointed that there is no 24-hour clock on this. So most of Europe uses a 24-hour clock, so you have like 13:30 or 14:45, and it's really disorienting because you're used to that 24-hour time. And this is primarily, well, it's a watch is half the name, so I would expect that. Maybe it's in there somewhere. Maybe there's some weird key combination I have to push to get there. But yeah, it's been disappointing. But I mean, there's. Really cute. This is so cool. And you see the seconds time right there. It's a nice attention to detail. Everywhere in this machine, you just see attention to detail. And you can interact with it, like hold those the flashes. Hold A for 10 seconds and you go into the special song mode. And you can hit this to put lots of enemies on the screen. That usually works. This time it's not doing it. There's also different modes, so if you do this, you get different screens. Now let's look at the packaging. They've done an amazing job on this. See, this is the main packaging, but when you take it off, you reveal that the original design of the Game & Watch, which is really cool. And on the back, they do the same. You've got the screenshots and a quick message there. And here we can see, focus it, yeah. Kein Netzteil enthalten, Füllung nicht inbegriffen, Informationen auf der Rückseite, mehr Informationen auf der Achterkant. So, quick message in German and Dutch. And on this side we have a short, more legal message than anything else. But zur Verwendung dieses Systems wird ein Nintendo USB-Netzteil CLV003 separat erhältlich oder ein anderes kompatibles USB-Netzteil benötigt. Obwohl einige USB-kompatible Geräte möglicherweise in der Lage sind, das System mit Strom zu versorgen, kann Nintendo keine Empfehlungen zu spezifischen Geräten aussprechen. Beachten Sie bitte die Anweisungen von Datenblättern zu deren Geräten. Um dieses System zu gebrauchen, habe ich ein Nintendo USB Füding CLV003 wurde apart verkauft. Auf andere USB-unterstützende Füding nodig. Hoewel sommige USB-unterstützende Apparaten mogelijk in staat zijn, um het System von Strom zu vorziehen, kann Nintendo kein spezifisches Apparat anraten. Volg die instructies die bij een door derden ontwikkeld apparaat geleverd zijn, zorgvuldig op. So, I know our viewer from the Netherlands, Tanya, will probably be able to critique my Dutch on that. So, that was fun. All right, one last thing. I'm finding it interesting. I looked at the little manual, which is more of a safety guide that came with it, and I was amused that when I went to this website for more information about how to use your system, the European page doesn't exist. It could be because it's going to be released tomorrow. And the Australian New Zealand page took you to a generic Nintendo page. So I found that interesting. Hopefully, by the time this comes out, they'll have those websites up and running. So, a quick pros and cons. Pros, this is a beautiful device. Amazing pixel perfect screen Excellent build quality, and that is metal in the front. Perfect sound at all volumes. Auto-save games on exit. Smart power saving. It sleeps after 3 minutes, and it's always on when it's connected to power, which is also nice. You can use it as a clock. Unfortunately, I have to say, from my personal usage, the fun dies rather quickly. I played it for about a half hour, and then I was like, okay, that was nice. I'm kind of bored of these games now. They don't really hold up to modern times. But it's really cool. So it's impossible to add more games. So I know that the hackers community out there will give it a shot. I connected this to USB to Mac, Windows, and Linux, and it didn't recognize it. So there might be some special button combination you have to push to get it into some mode that it reads it, or maybe you can do it over FTP. Or I'm sure people are going to be taking this apart as well. I'm not really a hardware guy, so I'm not going to be taking mine apart. But I'm sure that video will come out somewhere on the internet. I'm disappointed it misses a 24-hour clock, because that's the way I usually read time here in Europe. There is no kickstand, so you have to have something like this if you want to hold it nicely. No headphone jack, so you can't play it when the other people are around you unless you play it without sound. And I just find in general there's better ways to play Mario Brothers if that's what you want to do. So thanks for joining me, and now I'm going to leave you out with watching the game for a few minutes. I'm going to go back actually to footage of hitting noon so you can see what it looks like when it changes the hour. All right, have a good one. Like this video if you liked it. Subscribe, and I'll see you next time on RG Geek.